Andy here. One particular question that everyone is asking me is, should Oko, Thief of Crowns, be banned? Yes, should this card, this particular Planeswalker, be banned in Standard? Oko, Thief of Crowns, it's a beauty of a card, it's a beauty of artwork. It's one green and one blue, and it has a very, very good abilities. You create a full token, and the most powerful out of them is the target artifact or creature loses all abilities, and that's a 3/3 L creatures. Therefore, with a plus one, you will remove the most powerful creature that an opponent has, and it becomes only a 3/3 L. This particular Planeswalker is a very powerful Planeswalker, and with the ban of Field of the Dead, I think this card will see a lot of play, and is currently featuring in the best top 8 standard decks in Magic the Gathering. So should this card be banned in Standard? It's not an opinion, it's an analysis. I think Oko, Thief of Crowns currently will not be banned in Standard. Banning Oko, Thief of Crowns in Standard now means that you will remove one of the best cards in Throne of Eldraine, and remember, Throne of the Eldraine is the last set released in Magic the Gathering. Therefore, obviously, Wizards of the Coast wants to sell as much as that product as possible, and that means that removing the best card in that set, yes, Oko, Thief of Crowns is the best card in that set, is the most expensive. Obviously, there is the borderless card of Oko, which is a very expensive card. Removing this card means that you're removing the best card in that set, and that means you're removing your selling point of Throne of Eldraine. I'm sure if Wizard of the Coast will ban Oko, Thief of Crowns, not a lot of players will buy Throne of Eldraine. Let's see the price of Oko. Oko currently, its price is $43. $43, it's a very expensive Planeswalker card. You can see here that the card was already priced at $40. It went down during the spoiler season, and that release set, at the release of the set, the cards gained a lot of value, and now it's being traded at around $43. As I said, there is also the borderless. The borderless, and this is only my opinion, I think these particular cards, borderless, extended art, showcases, these cards are not targeting standard players or modern players. These cards are targeting collectors. Therefore, I don't recommend, if you want to play Oko, Thief of Crowns, to play or buy one of these cards. I will recommend only to buy the normal version of the card. They have the both cards have the same ability, so I wouldn't recommend buying this. I would recommend buying the normal card. It's $20 less. So why spend $20 for having a card that you're going to play with it? These cards are targeting collectors, and it's a good idea. Collectors like to collect these particular cards, these expensive cards. Therefore, these cards are for collectors. These cards are for players. The cards, as I said, is spiking both even the borderless, and the reason is, as I said, it's a very good card, it's a very powerful card, and it's being used both in standard and both in modern. When I see Oko in standard, it reminds me of another very powerful Planeswalker that was in standard prior the rotation. I'm talking about Teferi, Hero of Dominaria. Teferi, Hero of Dominaria was a very powerful Planeswalker. When it hits the battlefield, it was nearly game over. And even though Teferi, Hero of Dominaria was a very powerful card in standard at that time, Teferi was never banned. And I'm sure that Oko, considering all the things that I said, considering that's the most powerful card, the most expensive card in Throne of Eldraine, considering that Wizard of the Coast wants to sell that particular set, wants to sell Throne of Eldraine, obviously they are not going to ban the most important and expensive card in that set. And that is the reason why I think AUCO-TIF of crowns will not be banned in standard, because Wizards of the Coast wants to sell their most important product for Magic the Gathering, obviously most important product because it's the last set released. Second, Teferi was never banned. Why? Banning AUCO-TIF of crowns. Can leave a comment below if you agree with me, if you agree that AUCO will not be banned. I'm not saying that AUCO will be banned or not, or my opinion is to ban the card or not ban the card. I'm saying why the card is not going to be banned. The reason is because it is the best card you have for Throne of Eldraine. Here is the subscription button. You can subscribe to my channel for more interesting videos about Magic the Gathering and the collectible worth.